everybody, Flip and Danny here, founders of the Freedom Real Estate Group, family of companies, and welcome to another episode of our podcast called
Freedom Through Passive Income.
That's right. Now, today's episode is called When Getting Criticized, Use a Ruler.
So this is just something that came up a lot of times that when we're doing episodes, it's just something relevant that's happening, you know, at the time. And we said, hey, this is something important to actually talk about. So last night on Facebook, even Flip didn't even know until he woke up that I posted this
because I was thinking about it. Which happens more than you know.
Yeah. I was thinking about something and I was just like, Danny, stop marinating on that particular situation. It means nothing because that particular person who said that particular thing is not where we are. Mm-hmm. And I shouldn't be listening or even taking, it's not listening. I shouldn't be letting it affect my mindset or making me feel like I'm not good enough or whatever it is that my mind was going through. This person had, there's no weight to that person's comment.
Right.
So I started thinking about it and I was just like, man, that's a lesson that we all needed to learn because I have grown up going, I want to be nice to everybody and I want everybody to like me. So when you get criticism, that freaking sucks.
Yeah, it does. It stings.
Yeah, yeah. And when people don't like you or whatever it is, it always hurts. But the older you get, Flip and I know, we just don't care
anymore. I don't care.
And it's not that we don't care. It's just been easier and easier and easier. And when you're running a business, we always say, give me the criticism. Mm-hmm. Even though it hurts, we can't grow if we don't know what's going wrong. And that comes from team members. It comes from partners. It comes from clients. Like you get it from every, and when we are in the position of CEO, co-CEO, because truly we led these companies together, that's all you got is all the criticism, all the time, the fires, the problems, you know, the you guys suck, whatever it is. And you just learn to accept it. But last night it really kind of just, you know, it was a light bulb that said, you are just spending too much time thinking about this and that person has no reason, it just doesn't care anyway. Mm-hmm. So I don't know what you want to say about that, but I was going to apply it a little bit to everybody in their financial thing, right? Because you're a pursuit of financial freedom, right? Mm-hmm. Through passive income. Mm-hmm. Because you could have a family that doesn't do any of this, right? Doesn't invest. Mm-hmm. They're living paycheck to paycheck. And anything that you attempt to do or even talk about, you could be criticized. Mm-hmm. And just be like, you don't know what you're doing. You're going to lose all your money.
Right.
You know, or anything like that. And I'm sure you can give tons of examples. So part of this was not just to share the story, but to relate it to situations that other people might be going through, whether it's, you know, business like us, or whether it's this pursuit of financial freedom. And not listening to the people. Are they investing? The person that's criticizing you and telling you you're going to lose your money or it's a bad investment or you don't know what you're doing, do they know what they're doing and are they investing? Because that's when you could say, I don't need to be listening to that person. That's when that ruler comes out and that's what I meant by the ruler. Mm-hmm. Like judge by the person that you're accepting feedback from. Where are they in life? What have they done? And is their feedback even worth anything? I don't know how to say it any better than that.
Right.
I'm going to let you just kind of take over and say what you think.
Well, the funny thing was, is because you were talking about, you know, when we were running the companies and that's all we heard was criticism.
Yeah.
And all I could think of was Darren Hardy saying, that's right, the shiitake flows upstream. You know, and I couldn't stop laughing about that. But it's true, you know, and especially in today's age of social media and the Facebook, you know, on the interwebs, you know, people are sitting, behind their computer, and they're just typing. They're not talking to people. And it's funny when, you know, there's so much criticism, I'm glad I grew up before the Facebook, and digital cameras. Woo, boy, am I glad. You know, but people are afraid to criticize, you know, it's freedom of speech. And I understand that. It's just, it's, you know, it's like, sometimes you just want to tell people to just stay in their lane.
Yeah.
You know, and it's hard. And it's been a learning lesson for me, especially over the last few years of just getting to that point of, I don't really care what they just said. And I don't think about it again. And I move on.
Yeah.
Because, you know, they have no idea.
Yeah.
Who I am or what I'm doing or, you know, or what we're doing with the companies and how we're using things for our company. And it's just, it's like, it doesn't mean anything to me. Mm-hmm. And it took a long time to get there. That wasn't easy.
Yeah.
I think age and, yeah, just being cranky. You
know. And I will say, find your inner circle, right? Because mm-hmm. there is an inner circle who does understand this world. And mm-hmm. so if you've got some people in your circle that are, you do respect, have been there where right. you're going before, and you are going to listen to their feedback because they've got the experience and knowledge to be able to help you. Mm-hmm. And that's the type of, you know, people that you want to be listening to. And when it's tough, it's tough. But there's some merit behind the words, mm-hmm. right? They've been there, done that.
Right.
So listen to them because they've been through the muck and uh-huh. you're trying to avoid going through the muck. So I think that's the best feedback that we could get, because even when I post on Facebook, and I'll just randomly post stuff because I'm just super, like, I just share whatever. I just don't care.
Throw it out to the interwebs.
Yeah. And yeah. it's really interesting to me. The more I do it, the more feedback that I get, and the more I realize who's in my circle, what the opposite opinions are, because that's really educational mm-hmm. too,
oh, yeah.
is learning the opposite end. Like, even if you disagree with me, mm-hmm. I don't care. Yeah. I want to hear your opinion because it's just going to, you know, I'm going to gain more knowledge and my thought process might change. My perspective might shift mm-hmm. because you might say something. And there's been times where, you know, I would write something and people would, you know, comment. And then one person would be like, Danny, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, whoa, that just totally shifted my mindset.
Right.
Thank you.
Yep.
And that's really why I post a lot on Facebook, because mm-hmm. I swear sometimes somebody just turns on that light bulb for me, and it's been brilliant. So when you're getting criticized, just use that ruler. Know mm-hmm. who is it that is saying what they are saying. Is there any weight in their words? And if there's not, just disregard it.
Right.
Go find somebody else to ask the exact same question to, or get their opinion, and then use that valuable feedback, because that's the perfect mm-hmm. Opposition, I think, to that. When you're hurting in your head and you go to somebody that knows you and you say, hey, this is what happened. Is there merit to these words? Mm-hmm. And they say yes, or they go, psh, no. That's when you kind of really have that uh-huh. aha. Anyways, for me. So it's just a relevant topic that I wanted to share, talk about.
So the moral of this episode is just don't care.
Not always.
I'm just kidding. I'm kidding.
Pay attention to who you're listening to.
That's the moral. Sorry. Well, we hope that this episode was beneficial and informative.
Yeah.
Make sure that you're coming down to our website, freedomcapitalinvestments.com, to join our investor club.
Yeah.
The investor club, yes. Where we sit around and we're sipping. No, just kidding. But you'll learn more information about the things that we're doing here as a company and as investments and things like that. And it's different than the groups on Facebook and LinkedIn, but make sure you go into those groups to mingle with the team and ask questions or anything you might have. Make sure you're subscribing if you're watching on YouTube, and good reviews and recommendations and requests and all those things. You know what I'm talking about. Anyway, we always like to end all of our episodes with...
Invest smart.
Live happy. Bye
everybody.
And it's recording. Go. I got food in my mind, so this is going to be a fast one.
I hope that's a blooper. Food, food.
Hey, everybody. Flippin' Dead here. Voting the free community. Welcome to another episode of our podcast called... Like that?
Yeah. You talk faster than me.
Yeah. Once.
Nothing on this show should be considered specific, personal, or professional advice. Please consult an appropriate tax, legal, real estate, financial, or business professional for individualized advice. Opinions and information on this show are not guaranteed. All investment strategies have the potential for profit or loss, y'all.